Welcome back to Let's Play Fallout. I am Amethyst Lunatari, and we forgot at the end of last episode. I'm trying to replay as best I can the events that happened before the game crashed. Now, unfortunately, we had to play, or fortunately, depending on how you look at it, we had to play the Necropolis, the end of the Necropolis part over again, and I ended up not destroying the junk, which had the fuse in it, so I was able to fix the water pump. Kind of a cheat, but I mean, the only other option is to would be to go back and, you know, continually try to fail over and over again to reproduce what happened before we crashed. I mean, you guys saw it plain and clear in episode 36, somewhere in the middle. Well, actually not that far into the video. We had a few random encounters, and then we crashed. But we also went to... Not Junktown. Yeah, it was Junktown. And got attacked. And killed the guy there. So I want to remain true to the Let's Play. So I'm going to go back and re-kill him. I'm so glad we fixed the thing with the vault now. Vault 13 is fixed, and we went off the map. Here we go. Where are we? Oh, I guess we're there. Alright. We were at the entrance and killed this guy. But turn right back out and walk out of here. No, instead I'm going to kill you. Kalnor, that's his name. Where does he get these names from? Now I can shoot twice in a round. At least with this gun. Dead. 55 XP. So we had this gun. Desert Eagle 44, which I think we might have seen before. But maybe just for sale, so I didn't buy it. We can pick up all that stuff. Which works, and we got... Is that what that is? Leather armor? Yeah. Motorcycle, football, and other dangerous contact sports. I wonder if I can give some more stuff to Ian. Yeah, we're at 175 and 175. How much is this anyway? This armor is 8 pounds. That's 5 pounds. 1 pound. I do want to give him some of this stuff, anyway. So, because that's 1 pound. That's 1 pound. Okay, I'm going to give him some things, if I can, I don't know. Too bad the dog can't hold anything, but that would be rather unrealistic, wouldn't it? Oh, he already has 3. That's good, he can keep those. Alright. I can give them that armor and pick up the other armor. Okay, good. What's this? Oh, it's a radio here? And a shotgun? Okay. Well, now we gotta... Alright. Too bad I can't directly tell them to pick up things. I do want to check out the gun, though. Okay, give him this leather armor. Okay, good. I should be able to pick up all this stuff now. What did I actually pick up, then? Oh, just a radio. Okay. I guess I'll give him the radio, too. Sorry, guys. Yeah, he can't take it. Alright. There's no space left. Can you take it now? We just want to sell this stuff. Oh, we have shotgun shells. I took that. I did take them now. Okay. Is there... Okay, I got the shells. I just never got... I'm getting confused about what I'm exactly picking up here. He won't take that. He won't take that. He won't take that. Curious. Oh, I can't when I'm in this. Okay. So I'm gonna set to say. Buff out. I don't know. If he would just take these things. I mean, I guess it's fine if he does. I'd rather save them. Look, I don't know if he'd automatically use grenades and stuff like that. Electronic lockpick. How much is a shotgun? I probably still can't get it. Damn this weight capacity! So I guess the ammo, no matter how much you grab, always weighs 1 pound. Alright, let's just see how much I can give him. If I can give him anything else. Nope. Nope. Unless I give him knees for now. And... technically, he has room for that because they stack. I think possibly stackable items don't gain. Oh, curious. I'm still at 174. I guess that doesn't weigh anything. I am not solving anything. We're probably going to leave the shotgun behind. Which I guess we already did. It's still there from whoever we killed last time. It won't take anything. Nope. He refuses to take anything. All right. Leaving the gun. A dead Kalnor. He looks dead. Yes, indeed. Okay, so now we're heading back to the hub to buy and sell things. I think that's it, but I'll just click the little label maker thing. Encounter. Ah, rat scorpions. A pack of nasty rat scorpions strikes from the desert. Nice, one down already. That's two down. He was being incinerated. I'm gonna kick butt now. Oh, I want to check out that gun. I'm not gonna switch it now, but nice. We can't pick up the tail, so I'm not even gonna try. Not even gonna bother. We desperately need to buy and sell things, and then I need to buy and sell things on my person, and then get my stuff off of Ian and buy and sell that. I don't think we're gonna have to enough bottle caps. These people are gonna have enough bottle caps to, accommodate me. Okay, so the hunting rifle. Well, first of all, needs to be. Recharged. Or reloaded. Recharged. So this is 8 to 10 with a range of 40. Holds 10. What about this Desert Eagle? 10 to 16. Range is lower. It's okay though. 4 out of 8. 44 Magnum jacketed hollow point, which is. These are shotgun shells. That's better. So I'm gonna stick with the Desert Eagle then. I don't have that ammo, do I? 44 Magnum. What's this? Oh, that's it. Okay. So I'm using this, so rather than, of course, in addition to bottle caps, which they may or may not have replenished some of, or any of, I'm also going to be buying these 44 Magnum jacketed hollow points. I'm going to be buying super stim packs and regular stim packs. And the super stim packs, of course, are for use in battle. And the others will be, you know, to give to Ian and use on myself after battle. And besides that, bottle cap and get some more, I guess some more flamethrower fuel. I guess this, did I give that to him? Or I couldn't give it to him. It weighs 10 pounds. So I guess this will stack a certain amount. Because I don't think I'm carrying 70 pounds of flamethrower fuel. I'm not. Yeah. I can mess around with that. Find out for sure. Once Ian is leveled up. I mean, like emptied out. I can give him one and see if I drop 10 pounds. Alright, there's one way I tell. Okay. Onward. Onward. I think I took the longest way. How about save? Because I don't know why we crash sometimes. With it seems just random. Oh, and I need a Radaway. I could buy that from them too. Not completely sure if there's some. We might be able to take on that. That thing. What's the guy's name? I wrote it down. Yes. Where are you, dude? That's not it. I have a lot of post-its laying around here. Erwin. The quest to clear raiders from his farm. And then there's the guys in that house. Now that I can shoot twice around and I have a better gun, that's it's gonna help. Of course, I still don't want Ian or dog meat to be killed, so I'm going to hold off on that. I think we're going to the glow next, so let's go to the entrance. I just want to see if there's any. We've got a hustle and bustle of activity. I don't think anyone here actually sells anything, though. These are caravan guards. Now we can take on some of these caravan things. Wonder if I'll do that next. Caravan merchant. Don't let the bed bugs bite you. Okay, I think we gotta rest then. I think it is late. It's 962, alright. So I am going to rest until 6, and then give it another hour. Because 6 is usually too early. You should check out the merchant market if you want a job. Does anyone talk here, like John? Hmm. Stim packs and shotgun shells. We'll need those. So I'm gonna, like, pause here and buy and sell stuff, because you guys already saw a lot of that in a previous episode, and I have a lot of crap to sell. I am keeping this, by the way. The Vault 13 water flask. That is not leaving my side. I don't know if I need a water flask. We have not yet actually expressly, like, drank water. So, but that's for good time's sake. That's an heirloom. Kind of, sort of. A souvenir. Novelty. Party trick. So, yeah. I'm going to see what I can sell for 3 stim packs. And, yeah, I'm going to do is get rid of as much as I can. So, see you guys on the flip side. Just want to share this really quick about the Desert 44. Desert Eagle 44. An ancient Desert Eagle pistol in 44 Magnum. Interest in the late 20th century films made this one of the most popular handguns of all times. That's pretty interesting. Okay, I'm a bit overloaded now because I got a couple books. I've been literally, like, you would not want to see this. I got some coils of rope. As you can see, some rat away. I guess it might not. This weighs 10 pounds, no wonder. I got 3 coils of rope. 5 pounds for the books. 5 and 3. So I'm going to read the books now. I've been literally taking 1 leather armor at a time. I sold the jackets, then 1 leather at a time from Ian. And selling them in exchange for these 4 items that you can see here. I've been really not using any of his bottle caps because I want to buy items first, and then once they're out of stuff that I might want or need, then we'll start wearing down their bottle caps. That's my little strategy there. So let's read this stuff. Big Book of Science, a set of books containing information about different scientific fields. It weighs 5 pounds. Now our science is at 48%. The books aren't that expensive. I think the Radaway is more expensive. So, might as well. As time passes. I can't go up or down? What? You learn about the practical application of science and technology. Oh, now I can go up. You read the book. Okay, it doesn't say anything else. So now, 53. Okay, so increased us by 5%. Not a lot, but it'll help with science-y stuff. And then the Scout's Handbook. I sold like 2 or 3 of these before knowing that you could actually use them for something. I think this is... This might be for outdoorsman is 2%. That's horrible. Outdoorsman? Not sure what else the Scout Handbook would be for. So, stats here. I'm going to refer back to this and see if anything changes. But outdoorsman, 2%. Seems the most likely suspect. You learn a lot, can't scroll up unless I leave that, about wilderness survival techniques. Oh, that was it. 11%. Okay, so we gained 9% from that. Pretty sweet. I'm assuming you can just get multiple books and keep reading. That's what I'm assuming anyway. And now we're still over a total pound, so I'm gonna have to switch some stuff around. I guess give this rope to Ian. Maybe now he'll have a slot for that, because yeah, I need space for him to give me his stuff. Pretty much my stuff, everything that I want to get rid of, I did. I sold my gun, and I could also sell this ammo, but before I do, well, then again, I already sold the gun, didn't I? I could also sell the ammo. I'm guessing it does stack. It looks like it does stack, so 2 pounds for each, whatever stack. So I probably have a lot of pounds of that. So if I get rid of that. Anyway, okay. See you guys. Okay, 2 more books, and I was right. I was thinking, well, I don't think I said it when I was recording, but all that ammo, the weight does add up from it. So, stacked items, that's our answer. Stacked items, the weight, of course, increases. It's like it should be. But anyway, I got some more books. First aid book. A study book on the concepts and practical use of first aid skills. Much of the information is pre-war, however, it is still applicable to most in-the-field practices and skills. So, first aid is now 28. This is one way to look at it. 28%. Yeah, pretty horrible. You learn better ways to heal injuries in the field. 35. Up by 7. It's probably going to be helpful at some point. But whenever we get stuff like crippled right arm, I think this might be the doctor's skill, actually. I think if you get the first aid up really well, it actually heals, like, I guess, a decent amount of hit points. It takes time away. So the other thing is, what else do we get? Dean's Electronics. A study book on the field of electronics. A note on the cover says that it is for the budding young electrician and everyone. I'm guessing this is repair. My repair is at 40. I mean, could technically be science, but I think it's repair. So, repair 40, science 53, in case that's it. So, I'll look at it. You'll learn about mechanical and electronic repair procedures. So at 46 now. Pretty good. I'm bartering with this instead of bottle caps, so to sell the stuff that I need, so it's all good. I'm just rounding up with my bottle caps the amount they have, so it's been working out. You know, I'm wondering? I wonder if I can use the radio. There's only static on the radio. Alright. I wonder if I can use the guy. I don't know if I try to use the Geiger counter. This item can only be used from the interface bar. The interface bar. What's the interface bar? This? So you have to move it up here. What? You pressed. Oh, this is how we find out. You pass the Geiger counter over your body, it displays 0 rads. That's how we find out how irradiated we are. Cool. I like that. It's off, okay. Funny how it looks like it's like almost out of juice or something. I don't know if there's a way to charge that up or what. So hold on to that. How heavy is this thing? 4 pounds. All this crap adds up. I'm gonna give the radio to Ian. And this is ammo for my flamethrower, and I got more ammo. I got full metal jacket and jacket of hollow point. Using jacket of hollow point at this time. I think, I'm not completely sure, but I think it might be just more powerful overall and work against armored foes. So I'll use this until I run out, and you know, then switch to the full metal jacket. I'm not going to bother messing with it too much unless I have to. That weighs 2 pounds, so I guess I'll give him the electronic lockpick. I don't think he's going to be using this stuff. I'm not completely sure if he's going to use, like, if he'd use this stuff or the psycho or the buff out. I don't know. We might find out. If it tells us, he does it. Yeah, and I'll give him, like, the first aid kit. This is, like, specialty stuff. I'll hold on to the motion sensor. I'll give him the electronic lock pick. Yeah, just because I'm... As you can see... Well, 139. I'm getting, it's not too bad. I'll give him a few more things. Okay. I don't know, I felt like maybe I could try to go back... into this back room at the, Crimson Caravan, and there's a carry back here. Who the hell are you? If you want a job, you need to talk to Dimitri. Carry ain't so very in this game. So I guess there's no one else. I thought there was a named NPC who hung out in here, but... Maybe, will she barter? Isn't this where? Oh, he's here. I couldn't even see him. Kane. What's this? Psycho. Stimpak. And Stimpaks. I have a lot of Stimpaks. There's really not too much more I need to... Yeah, actually, I don't need to sell anything. What I would like to do now is buy some more Super Stim Packs and, I guess, some more ammunition for the gun. That's really all I need. So, thanks, but no thanks. I have, like, 31 Stim Packs besides what Ian has. What does that say? I need to talk to Decker. In regards to what? It's a secret. Sorry, but anything you have to tell Decker that can be... Anything you have to tell Decker can be told to me. I'm his right-hand man, and there's nothing that goes on here that we both aren't fully aware of. I don't have a job to say... I don't have an option to say... Let me see. I kind of want to go never mind now. Okay, it's about a job? Who sent you? No one. Then you'll see no one. Okay. I might deal with him later. I'm gonna run around, see if I can find any more ammo or super stim packs. I think we're done. I've seen everything in this whole area. I don't even know what this is. Yeah, I'll see you guys back. So I just ran out of here. I don't know if I've been in here. So... I don't remember. So just in case I haven't. Apparently... Running back in to see if he says anything again. Yeah, it's Jake's weapon and armor. That's Jake, obviously. Old Harold's good for telling tales. Yeah, I've met him. Keep your nose clean. Jacob, the arms dealer. I think maybe. Hey, how's it going, my friend? Looking to buy something? Yes. Now, the stuff he's got is pretty sweet. He's got a bunch of these metal armors. He's got combat armor. Which, I don't know. How much is combat armor? Whoa, oh my god. It must be pretty good. It's $23,214. So we just got a rocket launcher, which I don't have aptitude in. Just curious. Oh wait, I looked at the shotgun. That's a combat shotgun. First created in 2051, this lightweight, high-tech military-grade armor protects the wearer from ballistic trauma with hard plates made from advanced defensive polymers and ceramics. And features a flexible bodysuit. Maybe something else. I don't know how to move it down. Well, this just says it has 1 out of 1 shots of explosive rocket. I do have a couple explosive rockets. I could sell them. I don't know. I probably should. They're heavy. 14mm pistol. There's a lot of interesting stuff. Here's the rocket armor piercing. A rocket shell with a smaller explosive but designed to pierce armor plating. Maybe I didn't even look at the stuff in here because it was like so out of my reach. We'll take some of this. No one seems to be selling it in large quantities, so... Geiger counter activated. What's the difference? Sniper rifle. S223 full metal jacket. Flamethrower fuel, yep. I could buy more of that. Maybe I should, but... I gotta remember this place. I'm gonna come back for stuff. An EMP grenade. How much is one of these? Whoa. Just out of curiosity, because I don't feel like doing the math. It's 892. I remember to put that back. A frag grenade. I think that's different than the grenade I have. Or the grenades I have. Oh no, there's frag and also. I think we have enough for now. I really have not really used them. So. Flamethrower. Explosive rocket. A rocket with a large explosive warhead. So, unfortunately, he's not selling any of the super stim packs. But I did find those next door in that. That shady little shack with the guy who says, "What the hell are you doing here?" And you can buy a lot of drugs from him. So... yeah, a lot of stuff we just can't buy. Oop. So I'll take... yeah, I'll take... how much money do I have? So I should be saving up for the combat armor, I think. I'm guessing these are good against robots, androids, machines, that kind of thing. So maybe I should take a couple. I really just wanted to see how much one was first. So what if I have three EMP grenades? It's kind of stupid you have to do it like this. Okay, so now I need... 39. Yeah, I don't even know, so I'm just gonna go like this and subtract off. So put... ...68, I think? Math is not my strong suit. It worked! Okay, so I got ammo and EMP grenades, 3. So Sweet. I wonder what he has to say if I tell him this. Oh wait, no, good dog. Your selection is good, but I'm looking for something with a bit more punch. Any idea where I should go? Well, you might try the Gunrunners over in L.A. Boneyard. Oh, really? First, I've really heard much about the... I haven't heard anything about the Boneyard, have I? They'll probably have something to suit your needs. I've heard the guys at the Brotherhood of Steel pack some pretty powerful hardware, too. So you might check them out. Well, I've done that. Although, he is pretty awesome. Again, I don't want to risk looking at things or going into back rooms and getting people angry, because they have quite the firepower. There's a guy standing here. Well, now I can't get in. Who's this? Oh, alright. So yeah, this warehouse with that guy, crazy guy. And... I don't think there's anyone else at the Heights. I don't think there's anyone at the Heights that sells things. But I'll go check them out really quick. Yeah. So, yeah. See you guys. Okay, and I'm done. I tried to get into the Heights. Was attacked. It was like 3 in the afternoon, and I did not have my gun out. So they must have attacked because I stole the necklace. And, I killed the guy outside, Mr. Hightower's, home. So I killed that guy, and I stole the necklace, so... One or both of those things makes them open fire on us. I tried to survive that, and I killed a few of them, but we got killed. So I just... taking that out, because he wants to see me die over and over again. So whenever I get back in there, I don't know. Maybe when... after a few more levels, and when I get the combat armor, right? Which I'm assuming is better than the armor I have now. Yeah, I don't have to level up. I'm good. Yeah, we'll get to level 10 shortly. So next episode, guys, we're going to be heading back to the glow. We have rope now. So, going to be heading down. I don't know, those elevators. I think you need rope for them. I think they didn't work. So, I think there's 6 levels or something. On the 6th level is a generator or something like that. Or a power room, I'm not sure. So, yeah, be checking that out. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one. And always, seek adventure.